They cannot work to their full potential. And so that's why we need a true prophet.
Yes,
so
I want you to enter Nabiala
to review this false prophet so that we are not intimidated by them.
And
so sometimes we can say about intimidation.
The
spirit of Jezebel will cause us the spirit of fear in the people. Through intimidation, and the people who have the true gifting of God, they will be shut down and they won't operate in the Holy Spirit ministry. And they won't contribute much to themselves, even to other people's lives. They will become the prisoners of the caves until they are resurrected by a true prophet. And let me also put this or justify this. They will be resurrected by that true prophet who has a higher authority than that spirit. And another thing is that prophet could be one in that generation. Because God does not, he works with other prophets, but then he has that one
where
he sets up every center for everyone. And so when a prophet, these prophets are wounded, they will not contribute to the church. They will live in the shadows of the leader. They will never express themselves who they are. They will not come and tell the pastor, but what you've done really,
because
all the time they are intimidated and threatened. So they will live so much in the shadows. And that's what we are seeing currently. You cannot tame those people. And the gift of the church is shut down. I mean, the gift of the Holy Spirit is shut down. And when we come here now, of course, the Holy Spirit will start to be selecting the gift that was lost.
Omoyo mutukufu agenda za mucha buli chabo chabo chuchona echali chabula.
And even, yes, you can clap. And you start feeling confidence, even to speak the word of God.
Elamo otuka wano, otabiko kuhuli no mfumu, nyoyongere chikako chakatone chitufu.
That is not you, there is that power of the prophet.
Kakati, wajukuleto mwongere mingambe, no sikwe, mwabula, amani gano, agamela katambila, kunapio kutufu wakatona.
Because we are filled so much with intimidation, whatever we are.
Kubanga, tuwali tuwali usiwa kutisi watisiwa, yonaje tuwali.
And so when you come here, the Holy Spirit starts imparting that spirit of power within you.
Kati mwajeno, mwoyo mtuku unatandiko kuzamo mwoyo wa amani.
And also sober and sound mind. Eromo
yoyo mtukufu, natali koko mia wendo wosa yo, atengo ekola bulunji.
The person who is under intimidation cannot have a sound mind.
Omutu ye nani wasiwa kutisiwa jisiwa, teso wala kulo wosa, na kukola mitu ya mandesi.
You just rush into decisions.
Bulichasa na wo, apapa upapinasa na wo na hako la chaya.
You think the next day they're going to beat you.
Nolo wosa chencha
You don't even discern. So that's why the true prophets are revealed, so that people may not be intimidated. And number 2, Jezebel operation. Manipulation. Control. And deception.
No bulimba.
And so we're going to look at it in details. Because what happens is that Jezebel manipulates a nation. And also manipulates the churches. As long as there is authority, Jezebel is interested. So the school of Jezebel will use a lot of manipulation to achieve results. Let me say, if it is a church, the leaders of that church will be filled with deception. They will manipulate the entire congregation. They will even speak lies. How would
they
have been eating a supper with Jesus Christ? They will use a lot of deception to
practice you.
They will say, if you don't offer to God, and you become short.
No,
you won't do what you're meant to do.
But
even at home, you'll be as if you're seated on a stove. You always want to do what they told you to do. In fear of your child getting dead. And so the church will be filled with so much control. And the pew will be manipulated to the extent of doing things they are not supposed to do. Some people will be told that you have to remove clothes now. And they enter the church when they're naked. Now, don't you see God when he called Adam and Eve, they were naked? And so they will put every kind of deception for you to do things which you're not even supposed to do. In order this spirit to achieve results. Now there was one situation in Israel. And the Jezebel spirit manipulated everybody in the city. Because she likes, or that spirit likes residing in people with authority. She does not want to work more with slaves, people who are slaves who don't have authority. She doesn't
want to.
She knows that when she gets authority, she will achieve results much more. And so it operates much more in leaders. On this point for manipulation, and the people who are following these leaders, they will be manipulated, they will think that doing the things of God. And so in Israel there was also a situation that, like I said,
saidi mbera kwecho
yaliyo. King Ahab
had Kabaka Ahabu,
he desired to have a vineyard which was next to him.
Yeah, atuale nimio yemisa bibu ja Naboth.
Yes, Naboth was the owner of that vineyard.
Naboth yeyali nagini rusuko lolemisa bibu.
And so when King Ahab went to Naboth and said, I want this vineyard, I will buy for you something big.
Kabaka Ahabu weyagende ni Naboth namugamanti jagalo rusuko lolemisa bibu ne inyene wala wengendo kukuwe wanene.
And you know, Naboth refused and said, far be it, I cannot give you my inheritance.
Naboth inagana, namugama siza kukua, usikabala jajangre.
And so he was displeased, he went back home.
Ya, ina, techamu sanusa, nadaye wakawe.
And he was so sad, until Jezebel now, the masterpiece of control.
Na, nagiga, ukujusa uchalawe,
because I was already manipulated as a leader. Now look at this pastor as Ahab. Because Ahab is a pastor where he came from. He's interested in your cow. I'm saying, compare King Ahab to the pastor where he came from.
No musumba wewe yona jehova no chamu chifo chino.
And he wants a cow from you.
Kati wo musumba wo akaye akugamba njagala ntezo.
Oh, they want your inheritance.
Mwoni yao ayeri wo musika biya kusare ya bajajabu.
Now when you refuse.
Kati wo mwogana.
Now that is what happens. He has to go back to the spirit.
I know kudayeri mumyoyo je.
Until your life goes away and they take it.
Obujusa ngo bulatu wo bakujute.
And so that is what happened. We can read First Kings.
Kati yelelai wo mubwaka ya Israeli. Tugeende mu Bible museka ke tisoka.
First Kings 21.
Sura ya biri mwemu.
Verse 1 to 16.
Lunyiri lusoka paka lwa 10 na mukaga.
Olwatu ko oluvannyuma lw'ebyo Naboth Omuyezuleeri ng'ayina olusuku olw'emizabbibu olwali mu Yezuleeri okumpi n'eriyumba lya Akabu kabaka w'e Samaliya. Awo Akabu n'agamba Naboth nti, mpa olusuku lwo olw'emizabbibu mbeere nalwo okuba olusuku lw'enva kubanga luli kumpi n'ennyumba yange, nange ndikuwa mu kifo kyalwo olusuku olw'emizabbibu olusinga obulungi. Oba bw'onoosiima ndikuwa ebintu ng'omuwendo gwalwo bwe guli. Nao Naboth n'agamba Akabu nti, mukama akiddize eri gyendi nkuwa obusika bwa bajjajjange. Akabu n'ayingira mu nnyumba ye ng'anyiikadde era ng'anyiiza olw'ekigambo Naboth Omuyezuleeri kyamugambye, kubanga ayogedde nsijja kukuwa busika bwa bajjajjange. N'agalamira ku kitanda kye n'akyusa amaaso ge n'atakkiriza kulya ku mmere. Naye Yezebeli mukazi we najja gyali n'amugamba, kiki ekikunakuwazizza omwoyo gwo obwenkanidde awo n'okulya ne tolya ku mmere? N'amugamba nti, kubanga njogedde ne Naboth Omuyezuleeri ne mugamba nti, mpa olusuku lwo olw'emizabbibu olw'ebintu oba bw'onoosiima ndikuwa olusuku olw'emizabbibu olulala mu kifo kyalwo, n'addamu nsijja kukuwa lusuku lwange olw'emizabbibu olw'omusango. Yezebeli mukazi we n'amugamba nti, gw'ofuga nno obwakabaka bwa Isirayiri, gw'olokoka olye ku mmere ng'omutima gwo gusanyuke, nze ndikuwa olusuku olw'emizabbibu olwa Naboth Omuyezuleeri. Awo n'awandiika ebbaluwa mu linnya lya Akabu n'agissaako akabonero ke, n'aweereza ebbaluwa abakadde n'abakungu abali mu kibuga kye era abatuula awali Naboth. N'awandiika mu bbaluwa ng'ayogera nti, munangire okusiiba, mumuteeke Naboth waggulu mu bantu, muteeke abasajja babiri ababeyaali mu maaso ge, mumulumirize nga boogera nti, wakolimira Katonda ne Kabaka, mulyoke mumuggyeewo, mumukasuukirira amayinja afe abasajja ab'omu kibuga kye abakadde n'abakungu ababeera mu kibuga kye, ne bakola nga Yezebeli bw'abatumidde nga bwe kyawandiikibwa mu bbaluwa ze yabaweereza. Abo ne balangirira okusiiba ne bamuteeka waggulu Naboth mu bantu, abasajja babiri abaana ba Beyali ne bayingira ne batuula mu maaso ge. Abasajja ba Beyali ne bamulumiriza nga bamulumiriza Nabosi mu maaso g'abantu nga boogera nti Nabosi yakolimira Katonda ne Kabaka. Awo ne bamuggya mu kibuga ne bamukasuukirira amayinja n'afa. Awo ne batumira Jezebel nga boogera nti Nabosi akasuukiriddwa amayinja afudde. Awo olwatuuka Jezebel bwe yawulira Nabosi ng'akasuukiriddwa amayinja era ng'afudde, Jezebel n'agamba akabo nti golokoka olye olusuku olw'emizabbibu olwa Nabosi Omuyezuleeri bwe yagaana okukuwa olw'ebintu, kubanga Nabosi takyali mulamu naye afudde. Olwatuuka akabo bwe yawulira Nabosi ng'afudde, awo akabo n'agolokoka okuserengeta mu lusuku olw'emizabbibu olwa Nabosi Omuyezuleeri.
God bless you. Bernard was giving a testimony here.
Musumba Bernard yali awo obujulizi wano.
That he went to that church.
Yagenda mu kanisa eyo waggulu.
I've forgotten the name.
E kanisa yawo waggulu.
But he was told to sit in front.
Ne bamugamba tula maso.
That is how Jezebel starts to manipulate.
Jezebel mwacho ngatandika nga naye akalukukozesa obulungi.
He gives you a position.
Asoka nakuwa ekifo.
And exalts you.
Nasoka nakugulumiza.
And just know that he's taking possession of you.
Kati awo mani awakuwamba.
And that's how.
Kakati bwatyo.
They did to Nabosi.
Bwe bakola Nabosi.
Now, Jezebel this time didn't use intimidation.
Jezebel kumulundi muno tiyakola bya kutisa tisa.
Because people were used to intimidation. You know, you can use intimidation.
Bali bamumanyidde nti oyo mukazi atiisa tiisa butiisa tiisa.
And so she saw that if she intimidates, no one will respond.
Yalaba nti singa atiisa tiisa tewali ajja kuddamu.
In other words, she does not use one tactic.
Yeye Jezebeli takozesa kakodyo kamu.
If you know her from this, she comes
up. Jezebeli wali omuyigidde wano ng'ayita mu kkubo eddala.
And so what she did was to impersonate the king.
Era Jezebeli kye yakola kwe kukozesa omukono gwa Kabaka obubi.
And so she wrote a letter.
Jezebeli n'awandika bulungi nnyo ebbaluwa.
In the name of the king.
Naye n'agiwandika mu mannya ga Kabaka.
And it directed all the leaders in the city of Jezreel.
Ng'alagira abakulembeze bonna mu ggwanga lya Jezreel.
To proclaim a fast.
Balangirira okusiiba.
Now fasting is a godly act.
Kati mwe mulamu okusiiba kikola kya bwa Katonda.
But you see also Jezebel is also bringing it in a picture.
Naye mulaba ne Jezebeli.
When they want your possession, when they want your inheritance.
Kati olaba ne Jezebeli ng'alina obwobusika bw'omuntu bw'ayagala ajjeyo n'ekikolo eky'okusiiba eky'obwa Katonda akikozesa.
And so she told the leaders.
N'agamba abakulembeze.
Make sure you bring two chairs, three chairs.
Mukakase nti muteekawo entebe ssatu.
I think they could have even done a crusade. Mwoli
awo baakola na crusade n'aba.
This seems to be a crusade where everybody came and said.
Yes, mutu yenzewe n'enna yali azze.
So as I was saying, they told Nabosi.
Nibagamba Nabosi.
Now the village has decided to give you this position.
Kyekyalo kisazeewo kikuwadde akatebe kano k'oba otuulanga.
And we are giving you also two people beside you.
Era tukuwadde n'abakuumi babiri.
And that's what they did.
Bwe batyo bwe bakola Nabosi.
Now. Later on, because she had manipulated the people, she said, once you see him sit, once you see him sit in that
seat,
bring the witnesses. That this man has spoken bad things about God. And you should get stones and stone him. But Jezebel never gave a reason why they are fasting. They fasted, they could. And Nabosi was sick, but they never knew what was behind that fasting.
They were not taking
kayo nile pote bategera lwachi bali balagidwa bamukole bwe bacho.
And so Jezebel manipulated everyone.
Jezebel buli muntu yendoga kwanga ya Israeli ayino kuiza namukozesa byali atayagala kukuna.
Now it, what does it show or what does it reveal?
Kino chikulagachi oba chikubikulirachi
that in the church
ndi mukanisa
where there is manipulation control and deception
ewamera moyo wa Jezebel ngakola kukozesa abantu byatayagala n'obulimba.
She might not use intimidation
ayinza obutakozesa byakutiisa tiisa
but she will manipulate you to do things that you don't know or have achieved results.
Agenda okukozesa gwokola ebintu nawe byotamanyi nti obikola byasobola okutuuka ku kyayagala.
You will first not knowing you're fasting for the pastor to kill
ojo ojja kutandika n'okusiba naye nga tomanyi gwosibyako musumba kusaddaka zagenda okwekolera.
They won't give you the reason why.
They want to go and so ngalo acho ilo kusiba.
They will tell you musibe.
They want to go and buy you fast.
But they don't give you the reason why.
They want to go and so ngalo acho ilo kusiba.
And so you'll be under their control.
Kati unja kumela wansi uo uita wawe.
But what are they looking for? They're looking for inheritance.
Mubino yonna bagalachi bagala musikabu.
Now your inheritance is eternal life.
Kakacho usikabu kwebolina.
They're looking for your eternal life.
Baliko banonyo bulamu bwo obutagwawo.
So they will do so many godly acts for
you. Baja kukolera bikola bingi byebyo mwakatonda gwolowoze.
That they are serving God.
Jibaliko baweleza katonda omulamu.
And they will use other people who know you.
Era baja kukozesa n'abantu abalala bonna abakumanyi tetalo omulungi.
Manipulate you to the extent.
Basobola okukukozesa okutuusa kussa.
Until they achieve their result.
Okutuusa nga bo bafunye tebagala okufuna.
And so these are the notes that we can note from the story of
Kakati.
Jezebel and Ahab for us.
Yetu sobye
as a modern church under manipulation.
Yetu sobye kunabothi Ahabu ni Jezebel gwende kanisa bino byobo wandika mushabo.
Now we see that Jezebel can also use godly acts to manipulate the congregation.
Tulabye Jezebel naye asobola okukozesa ebikolwa ebyebwa Katonda okukozesa ekibiina gyayagala okukikozesa.
She will proclaim fast.
Jezebel
is like also the godly church.
Asobola okulangirira okusiba n'amakanisa gonna ag'obwa Katonda bwe gakola.
But in most cases where there is a fast, there is a death.
Niye bisere bisinga Jezebel kwalangirira okusiba wabeerawo n'okufa kubeera kujja.
Somebody's inheritance is going.
Wabeerawo obusika bw'omuntu Jezebel bw'aba aliko bw'ayagala okutwala.
And so but Satan's first normally.
Naye bisere bisinga
Satan's first the fasting.
Naye okusiba kwa Satani.
It does not just come.
Tekuja muzi.
It comes to take people's lives.
Okusiba kwa Satani kujanga kuzomtwalira obulamu bw'abantu.
Sacrifice.
Kutwalira musadaka.
At the expense of others.
Kulwa banana.
And Jezebel will use much more influence in this particular case.
Era Jezebel mubera mweti akozesa obumanyi.
And the control.
N'okufuga.
The entire congregation plus the leaders themselves.
Abantu bonna ab'ekibiina n'abakulembeze bennyini.
And so if the people of the congregation tolerate Jezebel.
Era abantu ab'ekibiina singa bakkiriza Jezebel okubeera mu bo.
If you ask, if you give the space to Jezebel manipulation.
Oba Jezebel bw'oba omwagaanya n'abeera mu gwe.
Your life might end like Naboth.
Obulamu bwo buyinza okomekerera nga Nabosi.
And your life will be shut forever.
Era obulamu bwo bujja kugalibwa ddala ddala.
Now in most cases now God has given us the Holy Spirit.
Ebiseera ebisinga omwoyo omutukuvu yatuwa omwoyo omutukuvu.
No, God has given us the Holy Spirit.
Katonda yatuwa omwoyo omutukuvu.
As inheritance for the life to come.
Era nga amutuwadde nga agenda okutusikiza obulamu obujja obugenda okujja.
And the reason why Jezebel looks for it is because of that Holy Spirit that you have.
Ensonga lwaki Jezebel akunoonya ku lw'omwoyo omutukuvu gw'amanyi gw'olina.
And the true gifting God has given you.
Era kulonya kulwekirabe ekyekitufu kyolina ekya Katonda.
The inheritance from Naboth.
Era bwe obusika bwa Nabosi.
And we know that God has given us so many things in
addresses.
There is faith, there is love. And so Jezebel wants to take them away from you. So if you give her a space or a place, so you'll be under control and direction of that spirit. And in most cases, the gifting that will appear to you now, those are manipulated gifts that will exalt you just like Naboth. And you will see people praising you all the time. That if you're not here, things won't go well. That if you're not here, we won't be able to see. So they will give you a high seat just like
Jezebel.
And if you accept it, the place was exaltation, that is a seat. So that you may appear to me like a god. And that is what Jezebel looks for to put in you so that he destroys you. And so if you see many leaders exalting you, beyond your measure, because you can always know that really this I don't. There is an inheritance they are looking for.
Mania, what won't see
and that person is operating under Jezebel. And also another note we see that the spirit of Jezebel targets people with gifting. The true gifting of the Lord. She wants them to be manipulated, to misuse them. And so they will even, she will use other even the friends, the people, the group to manipulate
you.
Just like she used the same people, the same regiment of
Naboth.
Jezebel does not use people you don't know. If she wants to destroy, she will use the people who know you more. Because I think they could have known that once we put for example, if you love self-glorification, you love praise all the time, now Jezebel will assign you someone who can do so. And you end up like Naboth. And so Jezebel will pile up or make her moves for a long time. In order to put it down. So if you expect intimidation, she won't come. If you expect maybe fornication, she might not come. She will pass through manipulation and put you to a level where you can be destroyed well. And so if the church is under manipulation, she will use all the ways to make sure that church is shut down. She will use she will use someone to manipulate almost everyone.
Yes, amen. Acha kose so muntu omu akose sawa tu wana asigate kibata ya gara kukola.
And our lives will be in danger.
Hiroga kwa pepe na mchapea
mkachama. So this time we see much excitement.
Hiramu misere singa mwadamo mchamu kilino mchua kuitini te.
On your life all the time.
Mwadamu mwadamu
just know your leading is the work of Naboth.
Manya, ukuto lugendo, ukubelea Naboth.
Because when God does something for us,
Baba katonda, watukolele chitu chona,
He gives us joy,
atuwe sanyu,
and He gives us liberty,
natuwa nemine,
to contain it.
Kukusiga langa, utambulila musanyu edu, yabelele seo.
But if you have that gifting from Jezebel,
neyemo ufune chinabo, ukubelea,
you see, you're above everyone. You see that you need a high seat. And those are characteristics we shall look at. We shall see the ministers or the people in the congregation, how can we tell the youth by Jesus? And so we shall stop here for today. For manipulation, we shall add on. We still have a lot
to share.
And so we are still looking at the prophetic ministry. We are still looking at the prophetic ministry in general. And we understood from the beginning that the reason why the prophetic ministry is here, or why God started the prophetic ministry, one was to let his people know his voice and understand him. And another thing is to reveal the things which are hidden. And so we are looking at the counterfeit prophetic ministry. We are looking at the ministry that mimics the Holy Spirit ministry. And the counterfeit ministry is originated by Jezebel. And so the spirit of Jezebel wants to imitate or mimic what the Holy Spirit does in the
moment.
And so it is the exact opposite of the prophetic ministry. But unfortunately, it also has gifting, but the gifting is also counterfeit. And so last Sunday we saw who is Jezebel,
and
where did she start from, where did we get the spirit of
Jezebel,
and we started looking at the operations of
Jezebel.
And now we are going to look much more about the operation of Jezebel. And we say
that
the church without a true prophet, and without the balanced ministry, the church will be so crippled, just like King Ahab and
Jezebel.
And so this church will lack direction, and the people don't take the instructions of the Lord. They believe under fear
in
and witchcraft will be so rampant. And the people of God will disobey God. And the church will be filled with prophetic
march.
And we saw the prophetic marches. This does not build your spirit. It does not build your foundation.
It
only leads you to the things of the world. Now imagine you're a human being and you're being fed the mash of the chicken. I don't think you can be healthy. And so those churches that are under counterfeit ministry and so they receive much within them which cannot build their spirit. And so what will happen is this. Instead of the church will be a disaster, the prophets will start prophesizing or prophesying the lives of the people. How you ate yesterday? And what food you ate yesterday? But it does not build your spirit. It does not bring you to God. And so when they say like that, you say, how did he know about what he ate? And then you exalt him and said, this is the man of God. And in fact, in most cases, what happens after when you've been taken over, manipulated, you forget about the will of God, you forget about the direction of the Lord, and you don't want to do anything with righteousness and holiness of God. And when they bring to you or they teach you about holiness already, you feel it is a burden to you. You feel you want to hear chicken of Guyawa. What you want chicken of Guyawa. Where is it going to pass through? You'll start seeking for miracles that you
need.
And so your mind is now set on a remote. Now that is the work of Jezebel in the church. And so we saw one of the operations was where you want to see that Jezebel is operating. Intimidation. And we saw that the Jezebel spirit likes intimidating the servant of the Lord. Just a moment ago, we heard from Pastor Israel. He was saying that his pastor,
the former, not his pastor.
He said, do not be in this place when we are praying. And do not, what? He said another thing.
But
when we are praising, still do not just go outside.
We are
talking about the grace. Now, that is the kind of intimidation I'm talking about. When they see that you have the true gifting of the Lord,
ekirabe ekituufu ekyakatonda batandika okutiisatiisa otandika okubeera mu bulamu
obwokutyane
bwonoowera n'okujjamu okutuufu tolikuwaayo okutuusamu omwoyo mutukuvu amugambye nti genda obeeyo mu mbeera bwekyo omwoyo omutukuvu abazze akuwa amaanyi n'obuvumu gwe osobole okweyongerayo
naye
omwoyo wa yezebeli bwajja yeatiisatiisa kyabo kya katonda
obaoliawo
omusumba oli yali yalaba nti musumba isirayiri agenda kujja mu mulembe
omuti
era ng'akozesa okutiisatiisa amutiisetiise naye
atiitire
abeere mu kutiitiira era bino byonna tubiraba nti eriya bwe yagenda ku lusozi Kalumeeru
eriya
yatta abanabbi ba Bayaali ebikumi bina naye oluvannyuma eriya ng'amaze okutta abanabbi ba Bayaali ebikumi bina
yezebeli
atandise okutiisatiisa eriya atiisatiisa eriya asse bannabbi ba Bayaali ebina
sawa
mukaka bwe siwera nga sinda bakufuula nga bwafudde bali ebina batemuze kati n'abasumba b'omulembe guno
batyobuwokebakugamba
gwe bw'otatunda nte eyo n'oleeta sente wano ogenda kubeera mu bikolimo era n'abaana bo bajja kubaka
ekikolimo
era ne bagatta nako kale ka mukolimire nakakati
and such kind of things, those are plays of Jezebel.
Kakati ebifo bwebityo byebifo yezebeli mwafugira
and so we saw that the spirit of Jezebel
omwoyo wa yezebeli akozesa okutiisatiisa okutuukiriza ebyo ye byabeera ayagala
era
okutiisibwatiisibwa okwo kwe tufuna mu mbeera ey'omuntu omuntu yenna omulamu katonda yamutonda ng'alina kubeera mukaka mwaweereze
katonda that means to make them live under fear and bondage.
Kati yezebeli akozesa embala eyo okubaleetera okubeera mu kutya n'obusibe
and you become coward
n'obufuuka omutiitiize nnyo
and you end up shut up in a cave
n'okomekeresa ng'oggaliddwa mu mpuku
a cave is a very good place to hide
mpuku kifo kirungi nnyo omuntu mwe yeekweka
but it is a bad place to live
naye kifo kibi okubeeramu olubeerera
and so some people can hide in a cave
abantu abamu bayinza okwekweka mu mpuku abamu basobola okuggalibwayo ddala ddala mu mpuku ne beesanga nga bannabbi abaali bateereddwa mu mpuku nabbi Obadiya
reduce the amount of the metaphors. What I'm trying to say is
ngezaako okwogera mu njogera ya bunnabbi naye mu nsonyi we maaso ngenda kwogera ebigambo byemutegeera
nti
abantu bano abatiisibwatiisibwa bakomekereza bali mu mpuku era ebirabo byabwe tebituukirira mu
bulamu
ebirabo byabwe tebigasa kanisa olinaokwebuuzaku
ndi
mu mpuku ekirabo kyange tekigaza oba ndi ku
lusozi
kubanga era ekyo ono yali aliko ng'atuwa ekigera ekya nabbi
yenna
bannabbi bonna abalala baali babagalidde mu mpuku naye eriya n'agamba nti nedda nze ngenda kuvaayo ndage katonda omulamu bantu bangi baali wano nabo bagalibwa mu mpuku.